Oh, I think this is the way that I missed. Yeah, so I think the way I missed is that the place where I went down into the darkness, down the spiral and then into the water, which put out my torch, it looks like these steps actually led up instead of going down. I didn't think to see whether there were two directions to go.
The darkness, that she's with the gods. But what if they lied? What if the darkness took her and trapped her here?
She'd get her mother out. Our mother doesn't. Where is her?
It's a trap. The beast is coming. Stupid baby.
Spreading. Father's keeping me away from the others. Away from Tilly. I won't give up. I'm not going to rot in here. I'm going to find Dewey.
Somewhere down there. Another one.
Thank you. Oof.
Grab it. I think I maybe need to look at this from the other direction or something. It's nearby, you can see the symbols all around here. Oh God. Here we go.
Her father tried to help her, but she wouldn't listen. He was doing his best. She never, ever listened. Why didn't she listen to him? Trying to help her.
He was trying to save her from the darkness.
Zimbel was right. Zimbel was trying to save her from the darkness.
Sigurd kills the dragon. Rian wants to keep Fafnir's gold all for himself. Rian also wants the strength and wisdom of the dragon, so he drinks its blood and asks Sigurd to roast Fafnir's heart for him. Sigurd does so, but when he touches the roasted heart to see if it is done, he burns his finger. Without thinking, he licks his finger and tastes the dragon's blood. In that moment, he understands the language of birds and hears them talk nearby. Sigurd's newfound power lets him hear the birds speak, and they say, Sigurd should eat the heart itself. Rian wants Fafnir's gold. Sigurd should kill Rian before Rian kills him. Sigurd should find Brynhild the Valkyrie, who sings a gentle song.
Sigurd heeds the bird's advice.
He kills Rian, eats Fafnir's roasted heart, and takes Fafnir's treasure. And he embarks on a new quest. To ride to Hinderfell and find Brynhild, the Valkyrie.
What's she doing? She's lighting a torch. She's making light. She's making a fire. She's got light on the other side. She'll be safe.
Oh, so now I know I need to go through the water and I need to light the thing on the other side to complete the M symbol. It looks like to reach fire I need to go through the water, which will put it out, and then put down this bridge. And come to this fire. Yeah, okay. Okay, let's do it. See anything.
Where is she going? Faster, faster, keep going, keep going.
What is she doing?
Stop, stop, keep going. Stop letting me know. Where is she going? Faster, faster, keep going, keep going. She convinced herself that there was nothing beyond its reach. How little separates us from what we fear.
Keep the torch alight.
Sigurd learns that Brynhild had once disobeyed Odin, and so he had her punished, stuck her with a sleep thorn, and put her body within a rampart of burning shields. Only a man who knew no fear would ever reach her. But like me, Sigurd is fearless and passes through the flames just as I did and wakes the sleeping warrior girl. She teaches him the secret wisdom of runes, namely victory runes, ship runes, runes for persuasion, runes for truth, runes for healing and help, runes for perception and power. Like Sigurd, the greatest young warrior of the North, you must learn the secrets of the runes to fight amongst the gods in hell.
Where
torch is really close to the water. Very heavily armored. Sound like 100 pounds of boards being smashed down into me. It's spreading.
Remember your training.
You
You can hear him. Is he fine?
People think of evil as an unnatural, invisible force, and so invoke the gods for protection. But evil can come from the hand behind the gods. A familiar hand, cold and cruel. He tried to fix her with his rituals, kept her trapped in that hole. She couldn't say which was worse. The darkness. Or the monster that her father had become. She couldn't fight them both. And so she left. Headed for the one ray of light that shone down on her. If she had stayed, she wouldn't have survived. Maybe Delian would still be alive.
I'm so sorry, my love.
She will save his soul. Even if this time she can't save her own.
Forgive me, Senua. I know you have no reason to trust me anymore.
Shadow, listen.
But believe this. It was my mission to make you hate. To hate the darkness with a passion so great it would focus your mind on this quest. For without it, I fear you would have left those slack. All this time, I wanted to protect you from the truth that would have destroyed you a long time ago. But you have conquered your darkness at every turn. You deserve to see behind the veil of darkness.
And take me into the mountains, trust me, as deep as we can go.
I won't stand in your way.
She has to trust him.
You will not survive what is in there.
I feel Hela's gaze searching for secrets inside of me. secrets that even I can't see. I'm not here to fight my past. I'm here for Dillia. I will fulfill my vow, whatever the cost.
No, she can't. It's too dangerous. She's
too weak. She has the soul.
I think this is a pretty good place to end the episode. So I hope you've enjoyed so far, and I'll be back soon.